For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a motherboard from Gigabyte that sports the new mid-range AMD B850 chipset and is targeted at folks on the lookout for a mainstream white-colored AM5 motherboard offering, the Gigabyte B850 AORUS Elite Wi-Fi 7 Ice. Sporting support for the latest Ryzen 9000 series of processors, as well as the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs, as well as the older Ryzen 7000 series of CPUs. We'll be taking a closer look at the specs of this board to see if it's any good. Let's get started. To recap, AMD launched its Zen 5 Ryzen 9000 series of processors back in August 2024, and it'd be par for the course for new processors to be launched alongside new chipsets and new motherboards. For some reason, AMD's chosen to launch its new 800 series chipsets more than a month after the launch of its Ryzen 9000 CPUs, starting first with the high-end X870E and X870 chipsets back in end September 2024. Fast forward to January 2025, we now finally have AMD's mid-range and entry-level 800 series chipsets arriving on the scene in the form of the B850 and the B840. To get in on the launch excitement, we'll be taking a look at the Gigabyte B850 AORUS Elite Wi-Fi 7 Ice that, as its name implies, sports the B850 chipset and sits within the AORUS series of gaming-oriented motherboard offerings at the higher end. As a B850 motherboard that is targeted at white-colored PC builds, the B850 AORUS Elite Wi-Fi 7 Ice comes in a box that sports a white and black colorway with the AORUS Eagle motif emblazoned on the front. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, let's have a look at the contents of the box by setting aside the board for the moment. First up, we get a Wi-Fi antenna in white that comes with the new Wi-Fi Easy Plug connector. We do also get two white-colored SATA 3 cables. And these are accompanied by a white-colored G connector that simplifies the process of hooking up your PC's front panel connectors to the motherboard. Apart from this, we do also get a metal AORUS case badge right here, a multilingual installation guide, as well as a regulatory information leaflet. Onto the board itself, we see that Gigabyte has gone for a full silver and white aesthetic. Even the various plastic headers and connectors are colored in white, making this board really suitable for you folks out there who are intending to build a fully white-colored AMD AM5 PC. As can be seen, the board comes with an integrated I/O shield design and has large silver heat sinks all around. Over on the rear of the board, we see that the PCB is colored in grey with a large AORUS motif for added visual interest. A nice touch, I must say, in spite of the fact that most of these motifs would likely never see the light of day inside of a PC case. Fans of integrated aesthetic LEDs for their motherboards will be pleased to note that Gigabyte has included RGB LEDs beneath the chipset heatsink, which do add a touch of pop to the overall appearance of the motherboard. The VRM heatsinks for this board are pretty decently sized, and Gigabyte has included 14+2+2 power stages with 60A DR MOS power phases. The B850 chipset has a single chip design, and the SID chip sits beneath this large passive heatsink right here. For M.2 drive cooling, Gigabyte has got you covered with a single large heatsink that provides coverage for all three M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the B850 AORUS Elite Wi-Fi 7 Ice comes with 4 DDR5 slots that, as of the time of publishing this video, comes with support for up to 256GB of RAM and the DDR5 8200 standard when overclocked. Naturally, the board also supports AMD's Expo technology, which are basically built-in overclocking profiles for DDR5 memory. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, we get a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C front panel header right next to the RAM slots and near the SATA ports along the long edge of the board, a single USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A front panel header that provides support for up to two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. We do also get two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports, for a total of four ports. Some interesting features to highlight. Back at the top of the motherboard, we get a start button that allows end users to power on the PC. A reset button, also termed a multi-key button by Gigabyte, that can be reprogrammed from within the BIOS to serve other purposes, as well as a set of status LEDs that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues. We do also get an onboard HDMI 1.4 port that forms part of a feature that Gigabyte calls Sensor Panel Link. Now, Sensor Panel Link is a great quality of life feature that taps on the trend of end users having a small LCD display screen as part of one's PC case, so as to display vital PC statistics or even animated videos of their choice. The said port supports a maximum display resolution of 1920 by 1080 at 30Hz. Moving back to the bottom edge of the board, we get a TPM header for an optional discrete Gigabyte TPM module, an additional reset header right here next to the CMOS battery, as well as a clear CMOS header. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a fancy-looking PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot sports Gigabyte's PCIe UD slot design that reinforces the slot for use with heavy graphics cards. As can be seen, the slot also comes with the PCIe Easy Latch Plus feature that helps make removing a graphics card from the slot less of a painful affair. That said, we do also get two full-length PCIe 3.0 X16 slots that each operate at X1 mode. Do note that PCIe 5.0 is only supported when you have a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. It's worth noting that the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. In the storage department, Gigabyte has included four SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management. For M.2 slots, it comes with a single PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slot and two PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots. Do note that all of these slots support NVMe SSDs only. M.2 SATA drives will not work with any of these slots. That said, the M.2 heatsink features a toolless design called M.2 Easy Latch Click, which makes removing and installing the heatsink really easy. Another quality of life feature that the M.2 slots have is M.2 Easy Latch Plus, which makes installing and removing a M.2 drive a toolless affair. Again, do bear in mind that PCIe 5.0 is only supported with a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. The Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. For audio, Gigabyte has included an entry-level Realtek ALC897 audio codec. Wired internet connectivity, on the other hand, is courtesy of a Realtek RTL8125D chip that provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, while Wi-Fi support is courtesy of a Realtek RTL8922AE Wi-Fi 7 part that supports the 160 MHz channel width and also serves up Bluetooth 5.4 support. In the cooling and RGB department, the board comes with six fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are three addressable RGB headers and a single 12-volt RGB header located in these regions. Moving over to the rear I/O, the B850 AORUS Elite Wi-Fi 7 Ice goes for an integrated I/O shield design in white, where the said I/O shield also comes with ventilation openings in the form of parallelogram shapes. The board comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 port that supports a maximum resolution of up to 3840 by 2160 at 144Hz, a QFlash Plus button that allows end users to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card, 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, 5 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors with the new Wi-Fi Easy Plug design, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. To sum up, the Gigabyte B850 AORUS Elite Wi-Fi 7 Ice is targeted at end users intending to build an all-white AMD AM5 PC at the mid-range. I must say, Gigabyte's really nailing it when it comes to their white-colored motherboards, where they're pretty much fully white in color, unlike some other competitor brands, where their white-colored motherboards tend to still have a smattering of black-colored components. That's it, the B850 AORUS Elite Wi-Fi 7 Ice also comes with a good array of modern features for a mainstream AM5 motherboard offering, where we get PCIe 5.0 support for both a graphics card and a M.2 drive, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet with built-in Wi-Fi 7, a plethora of USB Type-C and Type-A connectivity options, along with a whole bunch of interesting and helpful features such as sensor panel link, Easy Latch Plus, and so on. One downside worth noting is the fact that the board uses a Wi-Fi 7 module that doesn't support the full 320MHz channel width that you tend to get with higher-end Wi-Fi 7 modules. This is something to take note of, especially if fast Wi-Fi 7 networking is one of your key considerations. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.